What's up, YouTubers? This is MJ from Let's Fix It YouTube channel. And in this video tutorial today, I'm going to show you how you can configure a Tenma router easy and simple way. Let's go and do it. So here is the Tenma router which I have purchased online from the Amazon. The link is in the description if you want to buy this. Go from the link, and I paid 820 rupees for this. It's quite cheap and good one. As a Tenma router, 300 Mbps easy setup router, it's easily available online. We have some instruction manual here. It's a double antenna router, it's a bit small one. This is the Ethernet cable and the power adapter. Small and beautiful one, right? So it's a double antenna Tenma router, 300 Mbps speed, and it's small and beautiful. I like this router. This is the 6th or 7th router which I have recommended for my customer, so there is no issue. Everyone is quite satisfied with this router. We have some instruction manual here. Windows 7 or Windows 8. You can go through it if you want, otherwise you just follow the my video. It's actually very easy to configure. Okay. So back of our Tenma router, we can see 4 ports available for us. One is the WAN port. You need to make sure you should put your internet input link to this WAN port. And other 3 is the LAN port. One is reset button, and one is power plug-in. Okay, let's install the router first. This is the plug-in to this router. So, light is on. Grab my internet connection. This is my live internet connection, the RJ45 pin, and you need to make sure you should put on WAN port only, not in the LAN. The first one, left side first one, is the WAN port, so put it on the WAN port. Great. Okay, here we have the small Ethernet cable. You can put it in any of the 3 LAN ports, anywhere you can put. Then other end, we should go and put it on the laptop or PC, whatever you are using. Here I am using laptop, so I put it on the laptop. So I have plugged in everything perfectly, then I should wait for the Tenma widget to open in any browser. Yeah, it's opening. There it is. So we got the error message here. WAN port unplugged. No issue. You should go back to your router, plug in and plug out this internet pin, so that you can restart the router. You will see the message should go by then. Here, I think my wife my name as well. And I put a strong password here for the Wi-Fi password. And everything's okay, then I can just hit the OK button. Here it is. If you see the green check mark, that means everything's just absolutely fine. So we have a live connection right now. The connection status is showing that you can surf the internet. We have a download and upload speed. Then we have this stuff here. You can play around, showing that device, Atta's device is one. So it's because it's showing my laptop, because I am connecting the router with my laptop, so it's showing one. So if I go and connect my iPhone to this Wi-Fi network, then it's going to show us Atta's device 2. Let me go and connect my phone first. Here it is. My phone is now connected. That's why it's showing the Atta's devices too. So we have a couple of settings here on the left side of the panel. We have parental controls here. We can change some settings here. And this is wireless repeating. You can extend one more router from this router as a AP mode, access point mode. Changes wireless setting here. You can change your password here also, and you can change your Wi-Fi name as well. You can hide your Wi-Fi, you can disable and enable all this stuff. You can play around with this. So you have also internet settings here. Overall, this is your main dashboard for your router. You have the control for this, which you can say is a control panel. So it is a nice one, very user friendly. So for this time, this is the short video that I just created for you. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button for me. Have a nice day, guys. Goodbye and take care.